Types of physical topology. A physical topology refers to the physical layout of the network. It focuses more on how the devices are connected in the network. It doesn't care about how they are exchanging data with each other. And that is done by logical topology. There are 5 types of physical topology. They are bus, star, ring, tree, and mesh. Let's start with bus topology. Bus topology is the simplest among all 5. In bus topology, all the devices are connected through a serial cable in a linear format. A network using bus topology is called as a bus network. Bus networks were the original form of Ethernet networks using 10BASE-5 cabling standards. As you can see, the yellow cable on the right is 10BASE-5 and it was used for Ethernet connections. Now you can see the serial cable which is connecting all the devices is called as backbone cable. Bus topology is used for smaller LANs where computers are connected using thinnet cables. There are 2 types of cable, thinnet and thicknet. Thinnet is 10BASE-2 and Thicknet is 10BASE-5. So here 10 means 10 Mbps and 2 means 200 meter max. Bus topology is also used to trunk cables connecting hubs or switches of departmental LANs to form a larger LAN. In simple manner, it means expanding your network. Here are some advantages and disadvantages of bus topology. Let's start with advantages. It is easy to install, it has low cost, it is easier to add systems to a network, and it is great for small networks. The disadvantages of bus topology are, it is an out-of-date technology. It includes difficulty in reconnection and fault isolation. It is unmanageable if the network is too large. And if the backbone breaks, the whole network goes down. The next we have is ring topology. In a ring topology, each device has a dedicated point-to-point connection with only 2 devices on either side of it. As you can see, each devices are interconnected with each other having a point-to-point connection. A signal is passed in one direction from device to device till it reaches its destination. Here, each device has a transmitter and a repeater inside it. So when a device receives a signal intended for another device, it regenerates the signal and passes them along. If signal is not received in a specific time, then an alarm is issued, which will alert the device that data has not been received. A ring is relatively easy to install and reconfigure. To add or delete a device, we need to change only 2 connections. In addition, fault isolation is also simplified here. Let's talk about advantages and disadvantages. Let's start with advantages. It performs better than bus topology under a heavy network load. It does not require a central device to manage the connectivity between computers. Ring is an ordered network where each device has access to the token and opportunity to transmit. The disadvantages are that any modification in the devices can affect the whole network. Sometimes it may take longer time period to reach the destination if the ring topology is using a unidirectional communication. Although, this can be solved by implementing a bidirectional communication between the devices in the network. Next we have is star topology. In a star topology, each device has a point-to-point link only to a central controller, which is usually a hub or a switch. The devices in the star topology are not directly linked to each other. If one device wants to send data to another device, it sends data to the controller which then will pass the data to the dedicated device. Let's talk about its advantages. It is less expensive compared to the other topologies. In star topology, each device needs only one link and some I/O ports to connect it to other device. This factor makes it easier to install and reconfigure. Less cablings are required in star topology. Also, addition and deletion of any devices is easier. Fault detections are also easier in star topology. And if one link fails, the other links are not affected by it. The disadvantages are that if the central hub or switch fails, the whole network goes down. Up to some extent, this problem can be slightly improved by using extended star. In an extended star, the end devices are not directly connected with the central device. They are first connected with a switch, and that switch is connected with the central switch. But still, if the central device fails, the whole network goes down. Next we have is tree topology. A tree topology is a combination of star topology and bus topology. In tree topology, the nodes of bus topology are replaced with a star topology. Tree topology are used when we want to communicate between two networks, when we want a root node, an intermediate parent node, and a leaf node in a network. Here, a root has the highest priority, lower than that is the parent, and the least priority goes to the leaf node. Such type of structures are often used in central database systems, where there is one root, its intermediate parent nodes, and their children, which are called as leaf nodes. The advantages of tree topology are that it is easier to maintain, and fault detection is also easier here. Tree topology is scalable as leaf nodes can accommodate more nodes in a hierarchical manner. Other hierarchical networks are not affected if one of the hierarchical networks gets damaged. The disadvantages of tree topology are that huge amount of cabling is required, a lot of maintenance is required here, and if a parent node fails, the communication still fails. The next topology is mesh topology. In mesh topology, every device has a dedicated point-to-point link to each and every device of the network. The term dedicated means that link carries traffic only between two devices it connects. Here's a simple way to calculate the number of links required. Now, if we want to connect n nodes in mesh, we require n into n minus 1 divided by 2 duplex mode links. In the diagram, we have 7 computers. So, as per the formula, we'll require 7 into 6 divided by 2 duplex mode links. That is 21 links. You can check it out. We have 7 into 6, that is 42, divided by 2 is 21. As simple as it is. Let's talk about the advantages. The use of dedicated links guarantees that each connection can carry its own data load, thus eliminating the traffic problem that can occur when links must be shared by multiple devices. Mesh is robust. If one link becomes unusable, it does not affect the entire system. It will find another way to reach its destination. Fault detection is easier in mesh. Also have an advantage of security and privacy in mesh. There is a Wi-Fi mesh router where we can implement a WPA2 and AES encryption in it. The disadvantages are that it requires high amount of cabling and I/O ports. The sheer bulk of wiring can be greater than available space. Hardware required to connect each link can be expensive. Now, normally questions arrive like which topology is the cheapest, which is the fastest, and which is the most secured one. So the cheapest can be bus. Fastest topology theoretically is mesh topology, but while implementing a topology, the fastest is star. And the most secure topology is mesh. Thank you for watching.